Welcome back to SourceFed. My name is William Haynes. Today we're going to be learning about science. Hello, Internet. Science is like the coolest thing ever now, with guys like Bill Nye and Neil deGrasse Tyson going from scientists to rock stars, and I love it. Before Bill Nye, being a nerd was something you had to deal with, not something you could brag about. Now, someone can say you're not a nerd, and then people get mad. That's why today we're going to be discussing the top 5 science myths that have been debunked. Number 1. We only use 10% of our brain. By now, you've probably heard someone say we only use 10% of our brain, and it was probably Morgan Freeman. He said it in a trailer I heard a couple of days ago. Not true. It turns out the 10% rule is false. It's impossible and plainly illogical to suggest that our brain, the thing we use the most, is only using 10% of its power. If I chopped off 1/4 of my brain, I couldn't be like, oh great, luckily all my memories and motor skills were on the other side. Number 2, sugar makes children hyperactive. When I was a kid, my dad would always say, don't eat that sugar this close to bedtime, boy, because you'll be up all night. Father, you's wrong. It turns out there hasn't been much scientific evidence that concludes that sugar creates hyperactivity. Think about it. How do you feel after you eat a bunch of sugary food? Like climbing a wall or huddling over next to the wall and opening and closing the same apps on your phone? Scientists and logical people think that the hyperactivity is from the excitement of getting sugary foods, not the foods themselves. To that, I have to say, you don't know me, daddy. Ha, I'm right, as always. Not really. Number 3, lightning never strikes the same place twice. This isn't even based off of any recorded situations. It's actually a common mode of expression, meaning that bad things don't happen twice. Sadly, in real life, it does. Lightning is the materialization of a natural electrical discharge for a small duration of time in a high voltage between a cloud and the ground. So what you're basically saying is, nope, a cloud cannot be in the same place twice. I do not believe it. They do sometimes, pretty much always. Number 2, dropping a penny from a tall building will kill someone. If you were on top of a large building, say the Empire State Building, hopefully not during a lightning storm or a giant gorilla attack because you've seen movies, and you dropped a penny off the top of it, it wouldn't kill anybody. Since a penny weighs so little and is in the shape of a flat circle, it doesn't have very good aerodynamics and would flip around all the way down. Sadly, it wouldn't hurt more than if I just threw it at you. No murder for you. No murder at all. And finally, number 1, it takes several years to digest gum. Remember that time you swallow your gum and your friend was like, that'll be in your body for 7 years, idiot. And you were all like, it'll be in my body until I'm 27? And you were all scared. It turns out it's not even true. Apparently, your body doesn't even digest it. Since most of the gum other than the sweeteners is made out of rubbery polymers with glycerin and vegetable oil-based ingredients, things the body can't do much with. Once your body gets what little it can from the gum, the rest goes on through as waste, kind of like some people's college degrees. It's not your fault though. What's a science myth that a lot of people aren't aware is totally fake? Let me know in the comments down below. While you're down there, hit the like button, favorite, and subscribe to the channel. Share this video with your friends who need to learn them some. My name's William Haynes.